What a sight. A warrior true, if ever one there was. A fellow Drake warrior. Igon. Piteous Igon. Do you not remember? Conjure your past, how once you were, when fear was yet foreign to you. Drake warrior. Dear friend, grant me this one wish. Take this finger, my finger. Scale the Jagged Peak. Face Bayle the Dread. And when you do, summon me. Summon my soul. My limbs are limbs no more. My heart is twice over filled with fear. But a Drake warrior, I remain. And my soul yet lies on the mountain. Proud Drake warrior, I beg of you, scale the Jagged Peak, face Bayle the Dread, and when you do, summon me. Summon my soul.
Warrior true, what is it that you need? I remember that name well, the broken Drake warrior, driven by bottomless hunger and fiery ambition. Precisely what the Dragon Lord envisaged for men who partake in Dragon Communion. The mad hunger and fierceness of spirit that only flows from those young and short of sight. He rather reminds me of Bayle. In fact, such thoughts are unfathomable to ones as old as we. My dear Lord Placidusax, tonight, like every night, my solace is yours. May it grant you sleep and your place beyond time. I have broken my pledge. I succumbed to the deep slumber that was meant for my lord. Raven act of a foul and lowly beast. Forgive me, good warrior. My lord will no longer look upon me. I have fallen from grace. An old dragon, no longer. Go on. Leave me be.
Thank you.
Hereby vow, you will rue this day. Behold, the true Drake Warrior, and I, Igon. Your fears made flesh.
Finally, our wish is granted. Our dream, long yearned for, has come to pass. My lord was blessed with great insight. He saw in the insatiable hunger and fierce spirit of man the very things that would fell Bayle, our wretched nemesis. Warrior, you saw the strength of dragons. Whereas I am fallen, leave me be. Is that the truth? Never in all my years, could you inflict such cruelty? No, that is not for me to judge. Whatever your hand in it, it was I who succumbed to the sweetness of slumber. The fault lies with me. I may be fallen, but I need not surrender my honor. On second thought, I believe you do owe me something for the transgression. On a mere whim, you've stripped me of my one and only lord. As such, I require another. You, one day, may you become a dragon whole, a lord of your own making. Lead me, and I will follow, my good lord.
There you are. It took me long enough, I know. But I've made my decision. I believe it wisest to eliminate the Hornsent. If he were to point his blade at Sir Mesmer or Queen Marika, perhaps it would not matter. But vengeance changes a man. And one day, his blade may turn towards Mikula the Kind. Kindly Mikula is, after all, the true golden child. Even if he discards every last drop of his being, his lineage will always remain. I believe the Hornsent suspects what I have in mind. He never placed his full trust in me, even under the effect of Kindly Mikula's spell. He must have recognized something. The scent of the killer that slept within me, the stench of crusted blood. I will follow the Hornsent. To have his revenge on Sir Mesmer, there is only one place he will go. The Black Keep. Worthy Hornsent, I will dispose of you. Before your turn, I can no longer trust your word.
In the end, I knew this day would come. The nature of our kind, I am certain, will always show itself. In time, interfere not with my business. Seren, what could your purpose possibly be? I do not regret begging for help.
You've been taken in by the fight of the Hornsent. You have bested me. A single betrayal. Enough to turn the tides. Unfortunate. But I will leave you be. For now.
Do not interfere. This is my revenge.